Keep it simple, sucker. The KISS principle at its finest. We're talking about a snow pusher right here, folks. It's my favorite piece of snow removal equipment. I know it's not for everybody. We all have our own favorites, right? But this one is mine. And that KISS principle is really what it comes down to. That's like the motto of my life, right? Because if you follow my channel for any length of time, if there's a way to have an issue with something, I find it unintentionally. So let's take you through this today. But most importantly, we're gonna do a giveaway, all right? We're gonna give away one of these snow pushers. We're gonna tell you more about that, how you can win, how you can get entered later on in the video. And if you've already bought one or you're thinking about buying one, don't worry, for many of you, there's a way to be included as well. So stick around. So I really do want simple, you know, when it's dark outside, when the snow is just blowing in your face, when it's just cold and dreary, I don't wanna be out there dealing with problems. I just wanna get the job done and get back inside. And so unlike a snow plow or a snow blower, you have no moving parts on a snow pusher. You have no chute to clog up. You have no hoses to leak or break. Besides your quick attach, there's no other hydraulic or electric connections required, and you don't have to stock up on shear bolts because this thing doesn't use them. And pushers don't care about the type of snow. They're gonna handle dry, fluffy snow and the wet, heavy snow. It could be 2 inches of cleanup or 2 foot of deep snow. Any driveway surface could be cleared. It could be gravel, asphalt, concrete, or pavers. Now there's a lot of pushers on the market that come at a lot of different price points. In fact, we compared a couple of the most popular ones with Frontier and Land Pride last year, but let me tell you all the reasons why HLA is the one you wanna get. It's gonna be a completely bolt together design from your frame, so if you need to change it out from a JDQA to an SSQA, the replaceable wear points, including the back drag, the skid runners, the cutting edges, both on the back drag, and the main cutting edge, all of these are replaceable. The cutting edges are reversible too. Unlike virtually every other back drag on the market, which is this big hunk of steel on top, it closes off the box when you roll it forward to pull snow away from, it could be a building, your garage doors, a retaining wall, a parked car, whatever it is, it's gonna fully trap it inside there, unlike most of the others on the market that are only somewhere in the 4 to 6 inch range and leave a lot to be desired. A huge visual difference that you'll see between an HLA pusher and something else on the market is gonna be the lack of cross bracing between the side plates and the back plate. There's no need for that. They do a double sidewall plate, and the lack of cross bracing means that you're not gonna trap piles of snow in those corners. It's gonna fully release out of there. If you look close, you're gonna see the back wall of the snow pusher is actually rolled, or it's curved, radius forward. It's not gonna be vertical like most of the others out there. What this does is it allows that snow to keep rolling forward and make it a lot easier to push the snow, especially with larger loads. And we have thousands of these pushers out there in the market. So if you're watching this and you own one, we'd love to know what you think about it. Me standing here looking at this, it's just built like a tank. It's very robust, it's very stout. You're just not gonna damage this thing here. But those of you that have them, I'd love to know what your first impressions are when it showed up in your driveway. And besides pushers, we also sell snow plows and snow blowers. Snow pushers are gonna be the cheapest option as well. And that's partially because of the simplicity of it all, right? There aren't those moving parts. There's no gearboxes, there's no hydraulics on there. There's just nothing else that's needed. And so it helps keep that price point down as well. And so to get all that versatility at the cheapest price point for snow removal, well, that's hard to beat. Hey folks, a little reminder, if you enjoyed today's video, we want you to tag along. Subscribe down below. 75% of you guys watching are not subscribed yet. What are you waiting for? And if you own a tractor and you need something for it, give us a shot, see what we have to offer. Go to goodworkstractors.com. We sell and ship all over the country every day of the week. Now I'm a realist. I do understand that everybody's situation is different. You know, with a pusher or a plow, you need to have a place to pile the snow, and not everybody does if you're in very tight quarters. And we've done all sorts of tips too. You know, if you can plan ahead and you do have the space, don't stack up that snow on the edge of your driveway, push it back as far as you possibly can, so you can handle the snow load all winter long. Now, don't get me wrong, snow blowers are awesome. I mean, I love this pull type snow blower we have, but seldom do you see me without a pusher on the front of one of my tractors. They're just so versatile and so great for, you know, and that's the difference between a plow and a pusher. In my opinion, one of the big differences is you can do a long driveway with either one of these. You're gonna have windrows left over with either one of those tools as well. The difference with a pusher is the fact that those cleanup passes with the windrows, they're staying trapped inside the pusher, whereas a plow, you're just constantly pushing a windrow over and over until it's cleared off the driveway. That's really annoying. So it just makes it more efficient with a pusher to tackle those cleanup passes. But speaking of blowers, a lot of folks, it's really nice to have a front mount snow blower, right? But if you do that, it's not an easy process to take that blower off, put your loader back on if you need to use it, and then reverse that whole process to go back to the blower setup in the middle of winter. It's a time-consuming thing. We don't have endless amounts of time on our hands, and a lot of folks want the convenience of being able to swap attachments quickly. They need their tractor with their loader on it year-round, and so a pusher attaches right to your loader arms, and you need a quick attach, a John Deere quick attach, or a skid steer quick attach, but then you can go from your bucket to your forks, to your pusher, to your grapple, to your bale spear, back and forth, whatever you need to do. Plus, for a front mount blower, you do have to have a mid mount PTO or a mid PTO to run up front and operate that. You'll see we do have an option back there for a pole type snow blower, or you can get a traditional rear facing snow blower. Every tractor out there these days has a 3-point hitch and a rear PTO. We've even compared these against buckets themselves, and a lot of pros and cons either way. Obviously, you already have a bucket, so that's undoubtedly cheaper, but a lot of folks start out with a bucket and realize it's just not the right tool. You know, with a pusher, you just kind of push that pile where you want, just kind of lift the loader up a little bit and it stays right in place. With a bucket, every single pass, you're pushing it forward. You have to raise it up, rock it out, shake all that snow out of there, and then reset it down and repeat the process over and over. So there's just a huge efficiency difference between a bucket and a pusher, among a lot of other differences as well. Setup is really easy on the snow pusher. They're gonna come with a frame already bolted on, but there are three positions. So depending on how your loader hydraulics are set up, every machine's a bit different. You have three different mounting positions just to get to the right angle, the sweet spot. I don't think most folks have to mess with that, but it's there just in case. The skid runners on the side, each side are gonna be slotted up and down. And this is really how you control, well, whether your main edge is making contact with the plowing surface or not. So if you're gonna be on a paved surface, asphalt, concrete, pavers, whatever, typically you wanna be able to ride right along the ground and clear the snow as clean as you possibly can. I would avoid a steel edge and steel runners if you can. If you can opt for those options, the UHMW, the hard plastic runners, are gonna protect your driveway. They're gonna be quiet. They're not gonna leave rust marks. Plastic or the UHMW edges are gonna do the same thing. Quiet, they scrape very well. They're not gonna leave rust marks. They're not gonna leave black marks either. A very durable, very long-lasting material. Rubber is an option as well for the cutting edge. Not nearly as good as a hard plastic, but still an option. And just a quick reminder, it is in our listings as well. The UHMW, we cut these strips to length, but we just don't have the manpower to install it, but it's easy for you to do. So you just, if you have tools that can cut a piece of wood and drill a hole in a piece of wood, you're good to go with the UHMW. You just line it up here, the pre-drilled holes, just line those up with your template, drill a hole, add some hardware on, and you're good to go. Folks, we are proud to be sponsored by RimGuard Solutions, a liquid ballast weight. It goes right inside your tires, completely hidden. We're big on safety on this channel. These tractors are just too light and tippy right out of the factory. Not only is it gonna help with safety, keeping those rear tires planted on the ground, it helps with loader efficiency and traction too. The benefits of RimGuard include being the heaviest all-natural liquid ballast weight on the market. It's not gonna corrode your rims like the old calcium chloride. It's not gonna freeze, and it's available at over 1,000 dealers nationwide. Find the dealer near you at RimGuardSolutions.com. All right, now to that giveaway, okay? So here we go, folks. We've done these before, so I think a lot of you guys are familiar with the process, but we're gonna backdate this all the way to July 1st, 2022. That's it. It's as far back as we're going, July 1st, 2022. So even if you bought a pusher all the way back to that date, you can still get entered in this drawing. We are going to give away a 54-inch setup, all right? So anything above that, you gotta pay the difference, but a 54-inch setup, however you want it. If you want the back drag and the UHMW, if you want the works, you know, decked out with UHMW and a back drag, more power to you. If you want steel because you have gravel, that's great. How you enter is you leave a comment down below in this video. We are gonna let this run all the way through January 31st. There's 31 days in January, yeah? Yeah, good, good. Yeah, 2023, that's the upcoming year, all right? So you got a while to get entered. And again, if you already bought a snow pusher, July 1st, 2022, and forward is good. If you're thinking about buying a snow pusher now, go for it, leave a comment in this video and you could be selected to be reimbursed, but you do need to live in the lower 48 states, US only. All right, sorry, Canadians, you guys are great, you know your snow, but 48 US states only, all right? Lately, there's been some folks that are trying to take the fun out of this whole process, and we're not gonna contact you until after January 31st. We're gonna reply to the winner with how to contact us directly. It's gonna be at goodworktractors.com, so if you get a reply from text me on Telegram or some random phone number that you need to text them on, we're gonna ask you to email us and go through a verification process. There's not gonna be any extra cost to you, like some surcharge or something goofy or whatever it is that they're gonna come up with and try to scam you. So just ignore those and report them for us. And because of all those stupid scammers out there, we are going to contact you, and we got to go through a verification process to make sure you are who you say you are. We've actually had folks that we've had multiple times where there's been three or four folks that say, hey, I'm the guy that just won. And it's, you know, anyway, we're trying to keep this fun. All right. So just bear with us. We're doing the best we can here. So to get more information on one of these snow pushers or a snow blower or any other attachments for your tractor, check out our website, goodworkstractors.com. If you want to be in the know about future giveaways or you just enjoy watching tractor videos, we want you to tag along. Hit that subscribe button down below. It's completely free to you. I want to thank you for taking time out of your day to stop by. And until next time, stay safe. We'll see you soon.